a very special show here on Overdrive. I am Soini Dutt. Just a few weeks ago, our team embarked on a very ambitious drive. A drive in the Audi e-tron up to Ladakh. But that's not the only thing that was epic about this drive. We also teamed up with ABB, one of the largest electric charging infrastructure providers in the world, and Lion Charge to set up charging points across the Chandigarh to Ladakh highway. And this is that story.
Today we're setting off on what could be Overdrive's most ambitious project yet. We're driving up, as you can see, in front of a EV charging station. And what I'm getting charged here is the Audi e-tron. And we're heading up all the way to Leh. What we've done is not just driving this car up to Leh. What we're also doing at the same time is setting up a charging infrastructure from Chandigarh all the way up to Leh, which means in association with Audi and ABB, Overdrive is setting up 5 charging stations along the way from Chandigarh going all the way up to Leh. These 5 points are at Mandi, Manali, Jispah, Pang, and then finally one more in Leh.
Before we set off though, it was imperative we got the right tyres for this terrain. And as usual, Michelin stepped up to provide us with sets of Primacy SUV tyres that work brilliantly across all types of terrain. And whoever starts off a long journey with a car that's not squeaky clean everywhere. Enter Sonax, whose impressive range of car detailing kits got the e-tron and the Q2s sparkling and fresh for the tough days ahead.
The charger provided by ABB is a 22 kilowatt type 2 AC charger. It is one of the quickest AC charger setups anywhere in the country and is capable of charging, let's say, a 50 kilowatt hour battery in a little over 2 hours. However, the e-tron is restricted to accept only up to 11 kilowatts from an AC charger, much like other EVs, and this extends the charging time taken. However, the next generation of EVs will be able to accept the full 22 kilowatt from type 2 AC chargers. So, charging should be a much quicker affair.
We started off from Audi Chandigarh and unfortunately, there have been power issues in Chandigarh because of which we couldn't get a full charge on the e-tron. I've got a range of about 287 kilometers.
The effort was to get to Mandi, roughly around 210 kilometers away from Chandigarh. We had set up another charging point at the Patial filling station, an IOCL petrol pump. It's not as simple a journey as we thought it would be. The climb up to Patial saw us lose a significant amount of charge, and even the traffic and constant halts could barely juice up the e-tron. Things were looking tough. We made it to Patial with very little charge to spare. And to add to our problems, there was no power due to some construction work on the highway, which meant we had to wait until power was restored to the region. Nonetheless, we got around 50% of charge and were on our way to Manali well after sundown.
We're now ready to start off on our next leg, which takes us from this wonderful Himalayan resort in Manali. That's where we've set up the second charging station on the Chandigarh to Leh highway. But we are now heading to Jispah, to Padma Lodge. We are crossing over from Manali through the Atal Tunnel into the Lahaul and Spiti Valley. Now this is the first time that an electric vehicle, an SUV, is going to go through the Atal Tunnel. That itself is a momentous occasion, but then we're going to enter proper Himalayan territory.
Makes the most sense for a journey of this sort, a distance of about 700 kilometers between Chandigarh to Leh. The e-tron is best suited for it because, it's got the largest battery, first of all, 95 kilowatt hour battery. It is the largest, which means it holds the most capacity. Second, you've got 2 electric motors, one driving the front axle, the other driving the rear axle. But all of that, the battery management system also, depending on the mode you're driving in, whether it's the range mode, the efficiency mode, or whether you want to be in the dynamic mode, will divert power to either of those motors. So you can be front wheel driven, rear wheel driven, or all wheel driven as well. Third, it's got adjustable dampers, which means you can raise the height of the car or lower the height of the car. And in Ladakh, there definitely are certain sections where we need the additional ground clearance to get across some of the obstacles. Bad roads essentially. Roads which sometimes have, well, rocks strewn all over them. And third is the range. Audi claims WLTP cycles. Well, this 408 PS motor, the combined motor's output, with over 600 Newton meters of torque, will still give you a range of about anywhere between 350 to 480 kilometers, which makes it ideal for a drive of this sort. For those in the future who want to take this journey, undertake this journey to Leh, well, depending on the conditions, depending on the situation, how many more chargers can be added along that route, I think this would be a fairly simple task to do.
So we've come up to Jispa, which is a distance of about just a little short of 100 kilometers, and the e-tron's given fairly decent range today. We just lost about 100, 110 kilometers of charge, that's about it. But we're here in front of the charging unit, we're charging it, but there are immense voltage fluctuations. In fact, when we landed in here, there was no power, and this is one challenge that some of these regions in India will face as EV proliferation grows stronger across the country. Some far-flung regions will have power outages, will have voltage fluctuations, and while we're trying to and hoping that things get better, fingers crossed that by morning, at least 8 hours away, we get enough of charge in our battery. Let's see how it goes. Tomorrow, however, the big challenge starts.
Coming up, our journey gets tough and range anxiety.